we already talked about the good experiences, so I just want to kind of, you to kind of keep that in mind as we progress through the slides. Okay. So the first one that I have is just going to be two statistics that I found. So according to White House Office of Consumer Affairs, on average, low customers are worth up to 10 times as much as their first purchase. Right, so that being is because the more that they come, if you're a one-stop shop, they're going to keep coming, So of course, then they're going to tell people, right, and then the referrals are going to come, and then that's where that 10 times more comes into. White House Office of Consumer Affairs also states that a dissatisfied customer will tell between 9 and 15 people about their experience, right? So referrals are what keeps a business afloat, whether it be bad or good. If you refer somebody and they have a bad experience, then they're not going to come back, they're going to tell people you're going to lose business. Cool. With this one, it's just keys to a successful business. So empathy, patience, consistency, adaptability, clear communication, work ethic, knowledge, and thick skin are what I found when I was doing some research. I did look through a few different websites, but SurveyMonkey is what kind of like put it into the perspective for me, because it was all like in centrally one place. They were easy to talk about. So the first one I kind of grouped together was empathy, patience, and consistency. Not every answer in their parents is going to be the same, right? So we have to really take these three key things into consideration and just make sure that everybody feels important, right? All of their needs are going to be met, and not any one dancer or their parent is more important than another one, right? So that goes in the classroom and outside the classroom as well. Being consistent with patients and empathy, both in the dance classes and up front, will keep the parents happy, and the parents happy will bring referrals. So that's a win-win for everyone. Maintaining a positive attitude will also help to keep the dancers happy, and if the dancers are happy, having fun, then the parents are happy, right? So we just want to make sure that we create a positive environment for the dancers to come into. If they had a bad day, whatever the case may be, we want this to be a place that they can come to kind of release that, right? And then, according to McKinsey, 70% of buying experiences are based on how the customers felt like they were treated, right? So if they were treated well, they're going to keep coming back. If they didn't like their service, they're going to come. The next three are adaptability, knowledge, and clear communication. So the resource states that for every customer complaint, there are 26 other unhappy customers that remain silent. Right? So even though those 26 people didn't say anything to anybody, that's still 26 people that's lost. It takes more time and effort to make up for a bad experience, 12 to 1 to be exact. Where I got that from was Understanding Customers by Ruby Legner. She explained basically that it takes 12 positive experiences to make up for one negative experience. So you're going to have to work harder to make up for just that one bad day that you have. So you have to kind of make sure that you don't bring that into the workplace. Keep all of your personal stuff outside. And then just be clear and precise about whatever it is that you're assisting your customer with, whether it be in the class or in the front desk or with the parents. You just want to make sure that there's no room for error, no misunderstanding, things like that, right? A lot of situations will happen if there's a lot of miscommunication, there's a lot of feelings, and they'll get involved, and things like that. So if you're just clear and precise about what it is from the beginning, then everybody will be happy. Cool. The last one we're going to go into is work ethic. So that goes in the front and in the back as well. A disgruntled customer is relying on us to see their problem through to the end, no matter what obstacles may be in the way. So we just want to make sure that we listen, right? We don't let our feelings get involved, anything like that, because their feelings are just as important as ours. We are the professionals, right? So they are paying us to do them a service, whether it be in the front or in the back. So we want to make sure that all of their needs are met at all times, no matter what they are. We also need to be sure that we handle each situation in a timely manner, multitasking when necessary. So we don't want to have a line of people waiting. If it's, you know, around the time that we have performances, if people need permission slips and things like that, if it's a bunch of people, get them out. Don't make them wait for it or, you know, things like that. Just if we can do it in a timely manner, even better. In the back, it happens with the students, right? So we want to make sure that the students don't feel like they're working with just one specific person, showing a lot of favoritism, things like that, that everybody feels like their dance needs are being met in a timely manner as well, okay? And then the final one, in my opinion, especially in this industry, is you just have to have thick skin and just realize that there's always room for improvement. Not everybody's perfect, so you have to know that there's still stuff that you can work on as well, whether you're a dance instructor or you're at the front desk. In this industry, we have to remember that it is human nature to get upset when we feel like somebody is trying to get over on us, especially when it comes to money. So we also have to remember that that's not always the case. So we can't automatically jump to that conclusion, right? same thing with us dealing with the parents. We can't assume that they're feeling that way because of that. Just don't take anything personally. Remain calm and handle the situation with utmost professionalism. So just remember that in the dance industry, a dance studio is a revolving door. So you're always going to have people in and out, especially teams that come and go. So just make sure that you can... Cool. All right. That's okay. I'm just going to say my conclusion and then I'll piece it together. So in this industry, so we just have to make sure that the people that come and go, especially teams, they change their mind a lot, you know, things like that. So we just have to make sure that we don't take it personally. If they leave, they leave. There's going to be somebody that wants to take their place. Okay. And then we're going to go to the last slide. The last one is just a little fun picture that I put of our dancers. Just remember the customer service is a wide spread service industry, and it's always changing and it's super fast paced, right? So we have to just make sure we stay on top of it and we're constantly doing what we have to do to make sure that we stay to their needs. And then just keep up the great work and God bless our dance and feet. Thank you guys so much.
Yay.